there for Team Liquid. Like I already said though, like a ton of AD here for Golden Guardians, so it is going to have to be a control mage there for a Blaze Olive in the mid lane. He will take Victor into his matchup against Lucian.
And that put him in a position to get ganked, but now Nihilus just has to hold this, and burning so many summoners there for the top side without getting anything for it doesn't feel like a win for Golden Guardians when they're still bleeding on the bottom side of the map.
Yeah, Santorin here going to grab that Drake nice and easy. Lilia passive trickles in. And Santorin, as we know, is down to that bottom side alongside Tactical, so Jensen just going to back away. Dragon up, though, so maybe Golden Guardians feel like there's an objective to be taken. Top lane, though, still fighting. Niles back in. Dominus popped. Dismount here for Claire, but Niles looking good so far, but Alfari just does so much damage. The mini Claire just damage to remount. Needs to happen, and it doesn't go through. In a pretty tricky matchup to grab first blood solo, but I don't think they're done fighting just yet. However, Alfari will take the lead he's been given. As bottom lane also going to do the same here. Niles still fighting Alfari. This time, though, it's
all
not
game long. Ever since Centaurin invaded it, they weren't able to get the second one, but the third, they knew the timer. They saw that Golden Guardians was going to the top side. Just
pressure
say,
Kled naturally has in that 1v1 into anything on Alfari other than a flash being blown. So we'll swap up here to the top side of the map. Nubian Stixxay going to find one here, perhaps on a tactical. But he's going to pop the ulti here and flash away. Now Core JJ, look for the re-engage. Stixxay, the one locked up, is going to have to get himself out of there. Does have his flash, but now going to be followed to Santorin. Going to put the EEP down, and that will be the kill. As Renekton finds Rell on the other side, and now Niles in danger of getting dove this time by the rest of Team Liquid as Alfari is going to start things off. To the T2 he goes, Iconics here to maybe save his top laner. Kled's going to get dismounted and everyone's going to be okay. As Iconic is put to sleep, but Team Liquid still got what they came for here. A team fight win and the tower in top lane.
There is just not enough damage.
So I don't think Golden Guardians should be upset with how the game is going. I think we should just be impressed with how efficient Team Liquid are when they're playing their game. Is they going to take the mid with Shelly not even having to charge
easy
in?
For Team Liquid to actually deal with that, the Xayah is going to be able to just ult and get everybody rooted if you just run straight at him. You're also dealing with a very strong Lucian too, so I like that they're actively looking for something.
Right, but looking to, again, look for counterplay on the opposite side of the map. Don't want to fight them. There's Tactical in the mid lane. Getting on the stick save. Pops the Gale Force in the 1v1 and almost gets a kill. But Stixxay going to have to use the heal and the jump to get away safely. The dominance we expected from them. And again, Crumbs, I know you mentioned this to me off air, but Golden Guardians kind of need to win this game as Niles is in trouble. Going to flash out of there, but go to sleep. Ooh, pops the ulti instead, but Tactical's going to block it. What a beast as Niles will fall to Xayah. And now the rest of Golden Guardians getting flanked by Alfari. Stun lands onto a Blaze Olive. Newbie in the middle of everyone trying to make something happen. Stixxay going to bounce them back as Newbie does fall. Iconic also charmed up and killed by Jensen, who sweeps in for the double kill. And now asleep goes Stixxay. He's going to get shredded to pieces. And it's just a Blaze Olive left.
We've got the Renekton collapsing. And that's because for the last 5 minutes, all they have been doing is living inside the Golden.
So plenty of waves for Team Liquid to play with. Golden Guardians just have to fend off the assault for as long as they can as the tier 2 in top.
The Blaze Olive, and he can't be at two turrets at once, so this is most likely going to be the mid lane turret going down on this push.
Yeah, it is indeed going to fall. Niles there on the front side once again trying to make something happen, but Alfari is just going to jump in there, gets a big spin there for the health back. Using Call to Meek there and actually axing Stixxay's health play quite a lot, so now the Tristana can't commit because no health, and I was going to fall asleep if he stayed too much longer. So Stixxay are going to have to back away, and Team Liquid is
Golden Guardians. They just, all right, take them. They're spawning the Ganges. Keep killing them. Keep taking these objectives. There's almost too many objectives for them to take. They don't even want a base. They would rather stay on the map.
The side here. Have to celebrate how well they've snowballed this lead. They've got this soul so early. They're just looking to end this game maybe under 30 minutes if they can find the fight they want. Golden Guardians, so again, have to make their stand at some point, but aren't going to be able to save this bottom inhibitor. So perhaps just wait until the Nexus is a little bit closer here, because gonna have to be fending off supers regardless. Newbie gonna jump in, that's a good Magnet Storm. Damage is done, Jensen looking low, he's gonna pop and Tactical's gonna take out Iconic, but they do indeed get the kill to Ignite from Rail that finds that shutdown. But a double kill for Tactical, gonna make it a triple there as he takes out the Trist, and now it's just a Blaze Olive once again alive, and Team Liquid surprisingly leaving him alone despite the ace that's on the table. The Blaze Olive back towards the fountain he goes! And is going to live for a little while longer. Finds the shutdown on Death Tactical as Team Liquid, with no carries, are going to try and finish off this Nexus.
You do not perfect game the Golden Guardians. If anything, that is one thing they can say.
All right, there's the Bud Light Ace the Team Liquid have been looking for, and that is going to be the end of the game. 8 seconds for Iconic to come back. And slowly but surely, the Nexus Towers are going to die. Surely, no, they can't do it. Losing it to counter engage here, but Iconic perhaps off to the side. Niles already with the ulti, but not a lot of health left. Alfari onto Nubi they go. Core JJ with a follow up and see you later. Around the shield though, keeping him alive for a little while longer as Niles has found Jensen, but now he's dismounted and slain by Tactical as Iconic in onto Santorin, but plays off, stunned up by Alfari. Not going to be the last one left alive, or is he, as Kane goes down, but Stixxay going to save his mid laner with the buster shot. And now Stixxay's gone back in with the Gale Force. Absolute heroics from the Tristana, but will not be anything but another Team Liquid victory as they teleport in to take down the next Alfari. He's going to get the job done as Team Liquid going to knock Golden Guardians out of playoffs and tie themselves in the standings with four other teams for a second. Ablaze Olive once again offered up for the ace, but Team Liquid going to take the Nexus instead.
Such
the
a cool
KDA. It's not worth it. It's not worth the core. Oh, newbie back in, but the Nexus falls down as Team Liquid are going to take the win.
Oh, man. Santorin was so good.